I like to call this the bell bottom. You could use it as a trim or even on the bottom of a sweater or on the cuff of a sleeve to make it look a little different. Now, I'm not sure if you could see, but I have garter stitch in between here, and I did have, I think, 12 stitches to start out with, but only did about 9 stitches short rows. I'm going to work a smaller piece here and just do plain knitting in between the middle here. But when you look at the bottom, you could see how it creates that curve. Now this one here, I did too many rows for some reason. But it's only a sample, so I'm not worried. But I'm going to show you how I did this. Now I did already do up 3 bells here, as you see. I did start out with 4 rows. I turned the work around. I did my bell, turned the work around, did the 4 rows in it again, turned it around. So I'm at the end of this bell, and this is where I would knit 4 rows. Now it's really up to you on how you want to do this. I found that working with an odd number, in this case here, 7 stitches, but I have this one extra stitch just to, so it works out. After the 4 rows are knit, I will go ahead, and I'm using my small standard gauge garter bar. It's part of the connector that goes in between the 2 long ones, and it'll go on every other prong. Now, somebody had asked me if the standard garter bar works on the bulky, and yes, it does. The hooks are not too thick for this, but the prongs are in the way with the gate pegs, so you can't go beyond the gate pegs with it. So now, I have my carriage set to hold, so anytime the needles are out here in holding position, the carriage is not going to pull it back. On the brother machines, you're going to push in your part buttons. So I go ahead and hang the work back on. I push the work back, thread the yarn back into my carriage. Now I'm going to do short rows. On the side of the carriage, I bring one needle out, knit across. I bring the next needle out on the left here. I will hold my material underneath because it is small instead of moving the claw weight up. It's up to you if you're going to move the claw weight up or hold it. So I do that until I have one needle left in work. Now I want to reverse short row. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull 2 needles back into the forward work position, hold the material underneath those 3 needles, knit across. I'm going to take the last needle knitted and bring that forward to holding position so it does the automatic wrap. 2 needles back, 1 needle forward, until I'm at the end of my little sample here. Now this is where I'm probably going to hang my claw weight over there. Oop. Now I need to hang, and I got a big hole there for some reason. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back here to the beginning of the short row, and I could see my knit stitches here. So I could find the beginning of that bell, and I hang the end stitch on that needle. I bring all the needles forward. I'm going to turn my work using the garter bar. And I should have had the weight on there, but that's all right. Push the carriage back, make sure those latches are open. Now I have to be careful because I do have two stitches on the end here. Because I don't have the weight on there now, I push the work behind the needles, the open latches. I could go ahead and just bring these back to forward working position, or I could take my left side lever, Russell lever, so that it'll knit these stitches, and I will knit four rows. I put my Russell lever back to hold, and this is where I need to turn my work again. And just continue those steps for as long as you need. So now I'm back to doing the short rows again. Just making sure that your carriage is set to hold so it will not knit these needles. When you're done, reverse short row and turn it around, knit the four rows in stockinette so that it separates the bells. Now, depending on the yarn and machine that you're using for this, and how many stitches you're going to work out for this trim or this edge, will determine, and as you see here, I got kind of little points going from those little bells. And when you look at it this side, you have the purl stitches in between to separate those bells. Now, on the larger scale one that I did, if I was to flatten them out, I still get that little bump on the bottom, but it doesn't look good. So too many stitches may not work out, or maybe you just want it to fluff out like that and make it look like a ruffle. Again, it's up to you if you want to have the garter in the middle here, or if you just want to knit so many rows plain. If you're going to continue knitting, instead of turning around like this, if you're going to continue knitting, you want to mark that end row, actually over here on the right. It would be this stitch over here that I would mark, so I know that's the one I need to bring up in order to create this little stitch right here. So it holds that bell in place. Now, as you see, of course, I got the purple on here. I hung the work on the needles afterwards and just knitted up some rows. So I could have done this for us and then done my sweater bottom or even a sleeve cuff. This would make a nice little ruffle sleeve on a little girl, of course, or even for an adult. If you want to, you may be able to try the sew as you go, especially if you're just continuing up. You would take the bottom of the sweater or sleeve cuff and just work it in as you're going up. That way you know how many rows till you're done on this. Or if you were to count how many rows you get here, and then match it up to how many stitches you have on the sleeve cuff or on the bottom of the sweater, then you know how many of these bells you're going to get on it. Well, I hope you get to try this technique sometime.